Canada Nickel delivering next generation battery metals. The nickel demand is a leader among metals over the last decade with 5% growth, driven by continued strong growth in stainless steel with little contribution from electric vehicles to date. But nickel continued to have the highest demand growth over the major base metals in both 2018 and 2019. The recent Glencore presentation highlights massive growth expected in nickel demand from electric vehicles. By 2025, we have an electric vehicle growth path of plus 4% trend demand growth, requiring nearly 1 million tons per year of new supply. By 2030, 2.5 million tons, which is a double of today, is required. 2.5 million tons would require at best $50 to $75 billion of new investment this decade. Even Elon Musk said on a Tesla earnings call on the 22nd of July, "Please mine more nickel. Tesla will give you a giant contract for a long period of time if you mine nickel efficiently and in an environmentally sensitive way." That's what Elon said. Nickel price this year went already up from $5.10 to $6.50 per pound. The chart looks really good. Let's have a look at Canada Nickel. The symbol is CNC on the TSX, which owns 100% of the Crawford Nickel Cobalt Sulfide project. This is a new nickel discovery with large-scale potential in an established mining camp adjacent to existing infrastructure north of Timmins in Ontario in Canada, and is in the top 12 initial nickel sulfide resources globally based on metrics used by Wood Mackenzie. The initial mineralogy test results demonstrated 89% of nickel is contained in nickel sulfide and nickel iron alloy minerals in the higher grade resource area. The company had a new nickel discovery in the east zone and main zone, doubling the strike lengths of the nickel mineralization to more than 5 kilometers. A separate PGM zone was discovered and extended by 1.5 kilometers in recent drilling on the main zone and discovered parallel to the east zone. The whole project has significant expansion potential, as only a fraction of the flagship Crawford property was tested to date. Additional regional properties were added with similar ultramafic structures. The latest press release stated that 4 infill holes further extended the higher grade core at the Crawford Nickel Cobalt Sulfide project. All 4 holes intersected higher grade core lengths of 130 to 175 meters of 0.35% nickel. Higher grade mineralization of 0.35% nickel or better was now intersected across a strike length of 600 meters in the westernmost portion of the main zone and remains open in multiple directions. All 4 infill holes were continuously mineralized from the beginning to the end of the holes within the steeply dipping higher grade core, which will rise in true thickness from 40 meters to 160 meters. This shows the high quality of the project. Again, of high interest is that Canada Nickel has launched their wholly owned Net Zero Metals Incorporation to develop zero carbon production of nickel, cobalt and iron. The company has applied for the respective trademarks already and is completing a PEA on the Crawford project by year end. CNC has only 67 million shares outstanding and is still undervalued. The company is well timed, as nickel appears to be entering a super cycle which occurs every 15 to 20 years due to e-mobility and a supply demand gap showing up soon. Check out the company. I'm your host Jochen Steiger, Swiss Resource Capital, in partnership with Dukas Copper TV. Thanks for watching us and bye-bye from Geneva.